Action!
We're just making an ordinary adventure here. Ordinary fantasy. Nothing extraordinary happens in this picture at all. These kids are all kind of like friends. They're all sort of outcasts. They need each other because the more popular kids don't want anything to do with them. And they get bored one day and they have the most extraordinary adventure that any adult could possibly imagine.
Ready, and shoot it. Number one.
I think the uniquest part of working with kids in this many kids in the film is that every night I'm contemplating suicide.
Ah, look where our footsies are. Yeah, who's not on their Marxies? Ahazies. Okay, we go againsies.
Oh, well, I mean, grab his hand, he goes, because he's not expecting. Yeah, now you're screaming. Brandon, you're not gonna believe it. The thing I was starting on, I was gonna go in this thing and this thing and something. She said, and I almost touched me in the face with a dead fist. The things and the thing, and that. Action. It is the most difficult thing I ever thought I was gonna get into. I never anticipated what it was gonna be like, because individually, they're wonderful, they're nuts, they're the warmest, craziest little things that have come into my life. But in a composite form, you get them all together, and it's mind blowing. It's rewritten. All right, you guys know what we're doing.
Yes. Okay. He's got a plan.
What is the plan?
All right, now shut up. Shut up.
Booty trap.
You know where this takes place?
Yeah.
Where? Yeah. Tunnel. Now turn over.
What are the two candies you're buying?
We don't know this.
What are the names? You are a good kid. Ready? Wait for action. Hang on. Do it.
Stay with what you're reading. Practice, rehearse with what you're going to do. Rehearse with your props.
Where are you going to be? Get your mark. Be there. Concentrate is right. Thank you.
Exactly.
Now act. Now think. I'm serious. When he comes on you, you've just finished one. Take the last lick. Put it back. Look for another one. When he leaves, you found it. You go pick it up. Pick it up.
All right.
Huh?
All right.
Here's your right hand. Your right hand.
Ready?
You got it. Here we go. Ready?
Dick?
Huh?
Dick, is this time
Ready?
For real?
What are you gonna do?
Dick, this time for real?
For real.
Okay.
And yet, it's probably the most gratifying experience because it's an odd sort of a way. A lot of their energy and excitement is rubbing off on me. And it's very, very, very gratifying. Actually, when you break the script down with a creative group that I got like this, I've got from Mike Riva doing the sets and Nick McLean on camera and this wonderful, crazy group of kids and Spielberg looking over my shoulder all of the time, which I happen to love because I guess he's the biggest kid of them all and comes up with the best ideas. I just think there's not looking at it and saying I want one particular thing. It's all delicious. It's all ice cream and dessert for me. They're all every scene seems to be wonderful. I don't like the scenes with the adults.
Hey, you guys! I recognize these people.
What?
Wait,
the Patellis.
That's the one. Don't cut off my tongue. That's the guy from upstairs.
Well, I'm just an ordinary nice mother of two. Extraordinary nasty boys.
No, well, you don't strike me as an actor. It's a nice part of it. It's everything I've seen you do hasn't been acting. It's the two of you together are just wonderful. I mean, you don't strike me as actors. Have you acted before? Have you been in films or anything?
Show them the tattoo.
Oh, I have a tattoo.
Mom was in the Navy.
Okay, do it again. Come on, Mama. You in good shape today?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Here we go.
I think I need some dirt on me.
All right. Where's Sean? I never let the kids see this boat. They were banned from the stage from day one, from the start of its construction. And then the day they were supposed to come out of the chute, hit the water, and turn around and see the boat for the first time, I brought them all in, not blindfolded, but with a Baxter camera. They all knew what they were going to see, but they had no idea what it was going to look like. And so on film, when they turn and see the boat for the first time, I never really looked at Goonies. Maybe I made a mistake. I never saw it as a fantasy or a fairy tale. It's a true story. We just happened to be documenting the lives of a group of kids in a little town in Astoria, and the kids call themselves the Goonies.
Raise your right hand, everybody. Okay. Repeat everything we said.
I will never betray my good old friend. We'll stick together until the whole world ends. Through heaven and hell and nuclear war.
Good friends like us will stick like ours.
Now you're a Goonie! Okay!